阿弥陀佛。你怎么那么紧张？大家坐啊！
哇，师傅，我今天的模式呢是，师傅您讲一句，我就
翻译一句啊，
或者是师傅您讲到停顿点，我就翻到您停的点。
好，我不会讲太长。
So we're going to do a one-on-one translation where Venerable will give his speech and I'll translate right after.
This is a question.
对，
那是透过这个问题跟大家交流吗？
对，
好，
就是从这边引申，他们还有什么问题可以
就是交流嘛，
对，
谈的时候随时大家可以在在 feedback discuss
feedback and discuss you don't have to stick too close to the screen, but this is just a foundation and you guys can hop in and ask questions to Venerable.
第一个问题
first question
如何在忙繁忙的生活中恢复平静的心境。
How do we regain our composure amidst the hustle and bustle of our lives?
平时想多念佛和听经，但是事情一来就中断了。如何在繁忙的生活当中空出时间给修行的功课？因为看到这么多年轻人在学习正法，又在护持正法，所以真的是很欢喜看到大家。
Venerable is very delighted, very happy to see many young people, learning about Dharma.You know, the proper Dharma, the right Dharma here. So, it makes Venerable very, feel very delighted.
好，那佛法这个佛呢是觉的意思。所以觉悟了。那佛法就是觉悟之法。那等于任何问题啊都能解决。所以他在这觉悟之法，所以有佛法就会有办法，好像 Don't worry, be happy.
Buddhism is the Buddhism. Buddha means awaken, and awaken means problem is solved. No obstacle, because obstacle is resolved by us. So, in short, Buddhism itself.With Buddhism in our heart, if we understand Buddhism, master Buddhism, any obstacle we can overcome. So don't worry, be happy.
那佛陀有一句教诲的，万法因缘生。万法就是一切法，所有一切都在里面叫万法。那万法都是因缘生。那既然都是因缘生，我只要把因跟缘，比方说这个结果不好，我只要把因跟缘转变，我这个果就会转变了，所以没有事情不能解决。
The reason why don't worry be happy can happen in Buddhism is because Buddhism is based on cause, condition and effect.And once we understand the relationship between cause, condition, and effect, we understand that what causes the problem, which is the effect, and we go back to the cause of it, and we go back to the condition that nurture the cause of it, then we will prevent the bad result from happening. So that's why Buddhism is such a wonderful way.
哦，所以既然都是因缘生法，那首先我们自己的命运就能改变。哦，那进一步是改变生生世世的命运。
With this Dharma, Buddhism, which is called the Dharma, the ways of, you know, dependent origination, which is cause, condition, effect, 因缘果 we can change our destiny. And not just this current lifespan, but many lifespan. For.
好，那我们来看这些问题以后佛法怎么解决。
See how we use Buddhism to solve this problem that we have.
好，好，那刚刚我们有念到第一个题目了啊。
First question. Venerable just read it.
首先就是大家很有善根啊，因为在这么年轻啊，就知道要修行，这个就是善根了，不然就。吃喝玩乐，随波逐流。
Venerable, like to praise you all for having a great good root. You know, because in Buddhism, good root refers to your ability to awaken to the fact that we need to fix the problems in our life. Hence, we're learning this instead of indulging in pleasures like drinking, you know, over socializing and stuff like that.
因为老法师有讲过呢，现在这个世界归二郎神管，啊，一个是豺狼，一个是色狼，就是豺狼其实是功利主义，就变成唯利在追逐了；色狼就是享乐主义，放纵了。这两个很厉害了。所以大家还在护持正法，哇，那就很不简单，逃过了二郎神。
So, Venerable Master Ching Kong once mentioned, described the state of our world is governed by, metaphorically speaking, two gods. Right? One god is the god of.Well, this is a pun in Chinese, but I don't know how to make it in English, so I'm going straight to the point. One is the god of bottom line mentality, so any profit above everything, 功利主义. The second one is hedonism, which is Greek word for enjoying too much pleasure, overindulging pleasures of five senses, 无欲论者.
所以人生最大的福报啊，就是能学佛。为什么呢？啊，老和尚讲得很透彻，三善道消福报，三恶道消罪业。那我们是人，是三善道之一。其实来的就是你以前很多事积了福报了，然后你这一世来你就把它花掉了。但是在消花福报的过程呢、啊，几乎没有人不造业的，除非他学佛，他觉，不然他在花福报的时候，比方说，啊，家里有钱，啊，他父母给我钱应该的，他没有感恩父母，他在享他的福的时候，他首先就不感恩父母，甚至他会忤逆父母啊。那你看，他就短短几十年想完，又造了很多业，又跑到三恶道去了。三恶道一下去了五千劫呀、啊，好长啊！所以当人生难得、啊。这个我们先把这个宇宙啊，人生思考清楚啊，我们再来经营人生啊，很不一样。
So.Venerable once said, we all have our merits that we brought with us when we're born in this world. The way it works is the tree It's six rooms, right? Six rooms. Just to get things clear. The three fortunate realms, human, heaven, asura, they are spending the merits, you know, the fortune accumulated in past life. The three lower realms are exhausting all the bad karmas that you accumulated from the past. So as a human being, we all have accumulated obviously a certain amount of merits, fortunes in our past life. And if we do not know how to spend it properly, which is taught by the Lord Buddha, then we will spend it unwisely. So how do we say it's unwise spending of our fortune? Our parents, very easy. If we enjoy, in the process of enjoying our fortune, our merits, we are being disrespectful or we hurt our own parents, then we spend it unwisely, which in turn accumulate negative karma, which will lead us to a more misery, a place with more misery. We describe it as three lower realms.
忤逆父母啊，这个罪业就很大。包含在举一个例子啊，我们在享福啊，我们啊吃肉好了，你看人一天吃一顿就可以吃掉多少肉，他一年哇那个量就很大了。那《楞严经》上说的，人死为羊，羊死为人呢、啊。你吃他半斤要还他八两啊，所以你这一辈子吃了那么多生命，你后面不知道还多久啊。为什么人家转世为猪，他要做好多事好多事的猪，因为他欠太多肉了，他就要还了。对，所以三善道是消福会造业啊，所以知道修行啊，哇那人生就完全不一样了。
So Venerable is trying to illustrate the differences in knowing the Dharma and not knowing the Dharma. So knowing the Dharma means if we do not know about how to properly spend our merits, for example, just for diet, just by eating, eat meat, meat, and eat meat involves killing of the animal. And there is a saying in the in ancient Chinese phrase, when a person who likes to eat, say, lamb, pass away, the chances of becoming a lamb is very high because blood debt must be paid with blood, right? And if you eat them 5 kilograms, you need to return them 5 kilograms of meat. That's the concept. And also I'd like to add what Venerable has mentioned just now. Once, in Buddhism, it says that once we have lost our human body, it takes 5,000 kalpas, which ends here. Help us to recover. 补充。
啊，大家学佛啊，比我还年轻就学了，所以因缘呢都比我好。
The condition is much better for you guys because you guys has encountered Buddha Dharma much earlier than Venerable Chanda. So he's like I'm praising you all for able to.Avoid a lot of pitfalls.
哦，像这个 Alex，
Alex，
他还去教小朋友，小朋友就更早机会可以学。
Even better than us is like the students under Alex, the disciple student under Alex, who were, you know, heard of this Dharma even earlier than us, at a very young, tender age, so they can avoid even more pitfalls.
有一个佛门的高僧，他活到100多岁，前几年才走，叫孟参长老，他虚云老和尚的学生，他讲了一段话印象很深，他说人看清楚人生的最后一刻，再来经营人生可能感受就不一样了。那人生最后一刻是什么呢？我们在电视剧里面都看到，最后三长两短呢，最后那一口吸不起来，走了，双手双脚一摊，断气了。那个景象就告诉我们， 什么都带不走。当我们觉得人生最后是什么都带不走，那干嘛去这个积极去追求这个带不走的东西呢？那你就会去思考什么是带得走的。既然双手双脚一摊什么都带不走，那你这一生努力到最后啥都带不走那要思考什么带得走，再来什么才是真正留得下来利益自己家人的，利益这个社会或者利益后世的。这个是真的值得思考，什么带得走，什么留得下来。
So there was a venerable, very respected, venerable master Wen Chan. He's also a student of one of the very respected Chinese Buddhist monk, Xu Yun Aosan, very famous in Chinese Buddhism. And so he passed away, but before that he has left a very classical quote.He say that to live our life fully, we need to look at to the fullest. We need to look at the last moment of a human life to understand how to live truly and fully. There are two concepts under these words. First, what cannot be bought once we pass away? So when do we pass away? So he mentioned about the last moment of our life, breath.When we observe people passing away, they lose their breath. And so our life is in between the breath. And it prompts the thinking, what cannot be bought, right? We cannot bought, right? And then we think, what can be bought, even if we pass away? So that's the first question to think about. Second thing is, what can be left behind once we pass away?To our families, to our communities, to our societies, to our countries, to our world.
那能把这个事情思考清楚，看清楚最后一刻，然后思考清楚，再来经营人生呢，很不一样的。好，所以那个带得走的，就是我们所做的功德。所行的善，这个带得走。像这个念佛真心切愿呢，阿弥陀佛会来接你去极乐世界，你就不轮回，你就做佛了。或者你做的呢，都跟普贤行相应，这个普贤的功德力啊，就带你到极乐世界去了。这个是带得走的，那哪怕你没有到极乐世界，你所行的这些善，你在未来世，在人也好，在天也好，那都会很有福报。
So now that we ask the question, what can be brought forward? So understanding this perspective and look back at our current life, how we lead it, becomes more interesting.So, Venerable Wen Chan said, what can be left behind, right, is merits. It's our kindness, being kind, being good. And among the kindness, chanting the name of Amitabha Buddha is one of the best way to cultivate kindness because it can be brought forward beyond this lifespan. And also, in Buddhism, we have Bodhisattva Buxian,Universal worthy, he cultivated a lot of kind deeds, good deeds, and all his merits also dedicated to Buddha Pure Land as a result of his cultivation. So, those are the things that we can carry forward, can we move forward beyond this life?
我去新加坡好像有几个英文字啊，就是现代年轻人什么什么什么 O 什么 M 啊，就是意思就是及时行乐的那个。就是他们的一些思考啊，你们澳洲没有是吧？
there's a phrase in Singapore they like to use to describe 即时行乐。
他就是用四个英文字母。
哦。缩
写是吧？
对对，缩写对。就是每一个字的第一个字啊，然后那个。
YOLO。It's saying that, you know, we just, you know, enjoy life. 就是说我们这
四个字母，这每一个字的最前面那个。哦，不，哇，那这样澳洲比较单纯。
Never heard of it. It's a Singaporean phrase.
年轻人问我的题目。
YOLO 什么？
哎，应该就是这个字。
就是你只活一次。
YOLO， 对对对。
YOLO。有啊有啊有。You only live once. Don't fall into the trap of YOLO, because when the consequences really come to fruition, it's painful.
所以在儒家讲，就是大学之道，在明明德，在亲民，在止于至善。儒家讲跟佛家讲一模一样。菩萨道自觉。觉他觉醒圆满，你看不同的表达，完全的意境，这些英雄所见大略相同。
So in Confucian teaching, when you learn deeper, there's a book called 大学 I don't know how to say in English, but it's not university. 不是那个大学。这个大学是怎么解释？
大学之道应该就是。大人之学，就是你人怎么活得非常有价值意义，叫大人之学。
So it's a book of how to live a meaningful life, compressed in 大学。And in there it says that the path to live a very noble, meaningful life is to understand our true nature, is to understand 明明德 understand the virtues, the path of virtues 在于心里头。So, and to do that, we need to rest our deeds, you know, 身口意的 action, the speech, the thought, onto 自善, which is the kindness, the pure-heartedness. And in Buddhism, the way we learn, especially Mahayana Buddhism, 大乘佛法, is 自觉觉他, 觉醒圆满, to, first, we need to be awakened first. We need to know what's wrong, what's right. And then the others, we need to help other people also to solve the problems in their life by awakening. And then the third one is the act of helping other people is skillful, 圆满, perfect. So it's, even though it's a different tradition, but their will has converged because they are all arriving from the same place.
还像，我们什么是留得下来的？你看老法师，他圆寂了，但是你看他留下那么多可以利益人的，我们说法身舍利啊，这些教诲，多少人的多少人或者多少家庭，都因为他的教诲啊，改变了。呀，他的人生的价值还在继续在发扬光大。
Take an example of a dear. Take an example of our dear late Master Qin Gong, who has passed away. Even though his physical form has passed away, but look at what he left behind. Look at his example and effect of his action, of his speech, of his work, done. How much people was affected by him improved because of him. How many families was, you know, improved because of him. So in this sense, his life extended and immortalized.
像
Alex, just like Alex.
你看他二十几岁就开始教书了，哦，那这些孩子他会长大，啊，那他以后要当爸爸当妈妈，那他给他们正确的这些思想观念，就会影响他每一个小孩以后他的家庭。这个就是当我们离开这个世界，你看那么多人还因为我们而受到利益，这个就是人生价值，什么带得走，什么留得下。
So Venerable is converged to the first two questions that we talk about. What can we bring forward? What can we left behind? Left behind, just like, for example, Alex is teaching at a very young age, 20, and teach the young people about the path, how to be a better person. And if they carry forward into their own family when they grow up, many people will benefit because of this teaching. And even though she passed, she may pass on, you know, as lifespan ended. But what you work behind, what you left behind, will benefit many people, many generations. So this is what, this is how we find the value in our life. What does our life, does our life have a meaning? This is where we find it. What can we bring forward? What can we leave behind?
所以我们可以去感受一个对比，比方说一个人他一直在赚钱，他赚了很多钱，像台湾的企业家，他赚了很多钱呢，结果他死了，钱没有带走，然后他的子孙呢分财产分不平，他的棺材呢三年都没有办法下葬，因为摆不平，摆不平不能葬，死无葬身之地啊，他带不走的东西，结果留下钱啊，那个这个钱字左边一个金，右边两只刀啊，子孙吵架了，你的钱留下来不一定能利益子孙，反而吵架啊，这是一个情况。另外一个情况，我没有赚很多钱，我够用就好了，哎，我生活不缺就好，但是我去利益人，就像刚刚以 Alex 他这样，哎，很多孩子很多家庭因为他的教导受益了，哎，这样的人生对比起来差很多啊，一个最后死无葬身之地，一个 你利益那么多人，那你的福报就很大了，你的来世你要不到极乐世界了，你没有求生的话，最少人天两道没有问题。
So like take another example, like earning money, you know, make a living. Some, one, like there was a case where a very rich Taiwanese merchant, billions, millions of dollarsAnd what happened when he passed away is he could not be buried for 3 years. So he has to stay on the surface for 3 years because his generation, his descendants, or the descendants of him, trying to fight for a piece of his estate. And it took 3 years to settle. So he has to lay bare on top of the ground for 3 years. So yes, he has a lot of money, but the ending, as we can see,it's quite terrible. The other one is, say, for example, we earn just enough, you know, to survive, to make, you know, to live. Like, example, Alex, for example, who has engaged in education for the young people. And yes, we might not earn a lot of money, but what we did, if we, you know, what we did actually benefit the people who was being educated, and they carry it forward to their own family.And friends and communities. So that kind of comparison is quite stark, isn't it? Because the merits of doing so, you know, if we do not ask to be born in Pure Land, we will end up at least in human and heavenly realm. So,
yeah. 人生踏出的脚步大小不是最重要，方向最重要。
Doesn't matter how fast or how slow you go in your life. What matters is our direction in our life. Where are we going? Not how fast or how slow.
对，你方向对了，你走的每一步啊，都往好的目标。你方向不对，你走的再步伐再大，刚好背道而驰。
So if we go into the right direction, it will yield the result that we desire, which is happiness, which is good stuff. If we're not setting our sight on the right place, what we're going to do is create more suffering, more misery.
对，你是往极乐世界走过去的，还是往三恶道走过去的？这个才是最重要。
And to push it all the way, Pure Land is the ultimate goodness, ultimate bliss, 极乐。So either we go to Pure Land.Or to the state of ultimate suffering, which is the three lower bliss.
Wow, 他们照顾人的身体之外，现在还来照顾人的心理。
Not only that you guys are taking care of people's physical health, you're also taking care of their mental health, taking care of their heart.
Yeah. 好，他们说很好。过去生跟老和尚就有缘，对，不，人世间没有巧合的事情，都是因果相续的。
And Venerable say there's no coincidence in this world. Everyone has affinity with each other.
佛菩萨很厉害，买菜的时候都能制造机会。那个佛菩萨是同体大悲。像观音菩萨的千住祈求千住愿，所以他同体大悲呢，他随时都找机会要利益我们，所以连这买菜的时候，这个机会就成熟，就制造这些机缘，就是这一段也是要让我们认识佛菩萨的心，他是同体大悲，跟观音菩萨。千处祈求千处应，你一有需要有机缘，他马上就到了。
You guys heard the Bible right? Ask and ye shall receive. Same goes for Buddha and Bodhisattva. No matter where you are, what condition you are in, if as long as you have the seed there, Buddha and Bodhisattva will find a way. Like for in the case of Maggie.She's just going for you know, shopping in Chatswood for vegetables, and now she encountered the Buddha Dhamma by hearing. So this is how it works. It works in a very subtle and nuanced way. This is the heart of Buddha. Heart of Buddha.
像我呢，我遇到老和尚，遇到佛法就是，我有一个同事，他拿了一个录音带。根本没听过，然后他就拿给我，说这个是一个大陆人讲的，送给你。我都以为是大陆的讲的，我听，哇，怎么讲的，把道理都讲这么清楚啊、哦？我就觉得他是大陆的，其实老和尚在台湾。哦，后来我知道了之后，老和尚已经跑到新加坡去了。那你看，我这个朋友他都没有听过。他就透过他的手就交给我了。你看这些因缘，他冥冥中都有佛菩萨在加持。
For example, Venerable himself before his Venerable, his Charles, Mr. Chang, and when he worked, his condition is very one, very like I would say wondrous as well. His colleague passed him a recorded tape, like VHS tape or something about a Dharma talk.It's like, oh, this person, this a monk came from China, mainland China. So he's like, oh yeah, he's from mainland. So he hear it. But when he hear it, he felt everything is so clear. The logic is consistent. Everything makes sense when he hear it. So then he was drawn to it, to Master Chinko. And then he realized his venerable Master Chinko. By then he realized he already moved to Singapore. I think which is 90s in the 90s.So that's how condition works. in a very wondrous, very subtle way. And his colleague never even heard of Master Ching Hong. He just passed on to Venerable Chanting back then.
你看佛菩萨借由他的身体在晃，老法师那时候就对我们说，年轻人啊，发心呢，把身体借给佛菩萨用，出来弘护正法，我是30岁借出来用。
So Buddha, you know, like in this case, Buddha's borrowing Judith's presence, the body, to help how to build a connection into the Buddha Dhammas. And for Venerable himself, he borrowed his presence, his body, to Buddha at the age of 30. That means he dedicated his life into propagating Dhamma at the age of 30.So if young people has the heart to help to propagate the Buddha Dhamma, then, you know, the best way is we just put our whole heart and body to involve it. Yeah.
借出去之后呢，我也没想说会到悉尼来就来
了。Right after he borrowed.Right after he borrowed his own self to the propagation of Dhamma, he borrowed himself to Buddha. He already arrived, and not soon after he arrived in Sydney. Because this means he has an affinity with us. In Sydney.
那了凡四训很好，这个在企业界呀，公认。的经营之圣啊，圣人的圣啊，经营之圣是日本稻盛和夫啊。嗯，
稻盛和夫，
因为他白手起家，创造了两个全球500大，都是他亲手这样白手起家弄起来的。两个哦，一个已经很厉害了，他两个，后来他出家了。结果出家之后啊，他为什么出家呢？因为他查出来胃癌，他不慌不忙。你看他都有人生方向目标的人，他不恐慌哈、他就把两家公司安排好，谁负责什么了，他就退出了，他就出家去了。过一段时间他病就好了。结果呢？后来日本航空倒闭了。日本航空是他们很大的国家企业，这个倒了呢，对日本人的信心呢，会有很大的影响。然后当时候的首相鸠山由纪夫，
日本独立吗？
这我也不会读，鸠山由纪夫啊，就你就说当时候的日本首相就好，名字不会不用翻了。
好的，
亲自去请他，你可不可以出山来啊，来救一下这个企业啊？他答应了，还俗出来了。出来之后啊，用424天。不止把他救活了，只有400多天盈余啊，1800多亿啊日元啊。所以这样的成果啊，全世界好几千个企业家都来向他学习。他这个就是在企业的菩萨。他推荐给年轻人第一本书就是《了凡四训》。所以他学这个很好啊，每个人都想改造命运的、啊。这本书教得很清楚，
他就是榜样。
对啊。
So speaking of Liao Fan, which is your condition, Venerable has introduced a very very wonderful story. There is a sage of management, that's his title, that people give to him in Japan. I don't know the actual Japanese pronunciation. 稻盛和夫 I'll find it out later. He's very famous. And how he started from scratch. Oh yes, Kazuo Inamori. So Kazuo Inamori. Hi. So Kazuo Inamori. He's the sage of Japanese management. And he single-handedly built two companies.One of the top companies, listed companies, in Japanese market. But he became a monk afterwards. So how did he came from one of the most successful entrepreneurs into a monk? It starts with cancer. So he has a stomach cancer one day. And being a person as successful as he is, he's steady, he's calm, he's not overwhelmed by it. So he finds someone to take over two companies that he has.Founded and become a monk and focus on, you know, Buddhist cultivation. However, not long after, he has recovered from the cancer condition. However, afterwards, there was a situation in his country, Japan, where the Japan airline has encountered a serious recession. It's just like Qantas going to bankrupt, which is gonna hurt a lot of.Australian economies. Same for Japan. So it is so serious that the Prime Minister of that time in Japan asked this Mr. Kazuo to, you know, come out from his monkhood to be a layperson so that he can assist the whole nation to recover the economy through Japanese airline. He did that.You know, to save his country. And not just recover from recession, he made it profitable. How much more profitable? 1800亿, 144 million. So about billions of yen. Yeah, 80 billion, right? 180 billion, thank you. 180 billion. 我一直要翻一个亿是多少个 million？ 十个 million 嘛，对吧？一个亿。180 billion of Japanese yen. So he make it profitable, not just survive. For only like 424 days. And when people ask him, what do you recommend, you know, for next generation? He pull out a book, Liao Fan Si Xun, Liao Fan Four Lessons. And this is how you change your destiny. You should follow Liao Fan Four Lessons. And we all learn that.
现在这个时代生活不容易啊。他讲不知道命运在自己手上，他会很担忧，很惶恐的。因为他明理了，心才能安呢。不然啊，就每天可能会担忧，
浮浮躁躁。The reason why we have such a unstable, volatile mentality in nowadays is because we do not know how do we change control and change our destiny. Once we understand the ways to change our destiny, naturally our heart will settle down. We won't be affected by outside circumstances as much.
阿弥陀佛。这个也有佛菩萨加持他们家。
Their family were taken care well by the Buddha and Bodhisattva.
知道他们下一代会出来弘扬正法。
Because they know that they are the next generation of my family will be very important figures in propagating the Buddhism, the Dharma.
因为我们家也是在渔村。
So Venerable's family is also came from the house of fishing.
爷爷兄弟全部都是捕鱼的，到我爸爸这一代出来了，不然我可能也在捕鱼了。因为我爷爷很重视让我们读书，让他的子孙读书，就改变过来了。
Venerable's family, their family, his grandfather's generation, they're all like fishmongers. Only until his father, they turn around their family fortune.Because his grandfather emphasized a lot on the importance of education in turning our lives around. Otherwise, Venerable would still be catching fish.
Wow, 那你们家可以同生极乐国啊。
The whole family will be able to attend, you know, to go to Pyongyang. Because you're all part of it.
那是最圆满的，最圆满。
It's the most beautiful ending for the world.
对啊，不然下辈子都不认识他。
Otherwise, next life, if we don't able to attain, you know, reborn in Pyongyang, we won't be able to know each other.Once we wanted this next time.
好，那我们就题目交流一下啊。
Let's exchange our any question. Any question in your mind? Go. 来，
我们看第一个问题哈。
Back to first question.
如何在忙碌的生活中恢复平静的心境啊？
How do we regain our composure amidst the hustle and bustle of our lives?
佛法的修行啊，很重要的一点呢，在安住当下。人的心能安在当下呢，他就不能着急。所以事情可以多。心不可以忙，啊，心不可以跟着事情多而急。
Buddhism is about being in the present, in this moment, at this moment. You can have a lot of matters, you can have a lot of schedules, business and stuff like that, but your heart must be one. Your heart cannot be agitated with your matters. You can have a lot of stuff.To handle, but our heart must always have point of focus.
哦，就好像我今天上了一天班，我很忙，然后你就，哎呀，好忙啊，好忙啊，好忙，然后到了下班回来，哎，你就累垮了，哦，然后你说啊，我忙了一天呢，我来平静平静吧。好，这是一个情况。和你从一开始，同样的一天，同样的工作，啊，比方你在赶车的时候，啊，你要坐交通工具的时候，你就念着佛，啊，你上了交通工具的，哎，你听着经，啊，你虽然。这个时间都很紧凑，但是你的心是安定的。包含你在工作了，你在处理事了，你都不要很急很慌。很好的去沟通啊，很好的去做事啊。那你的心在整天的工作当中，它是平静的。纵使有起伏。也不大，好，然后一有起伏的，你就阿弥陀佛，哎，他就静下来了，哎。
So in our daily hustle, busy work rush, and the common scenario is where we finish the whole busy day, we come home and just take a deep breath and say, I just need to calm down, settle down. So what we can do.To make ourselves more stable in our mental state, despite the hustling and bustling, is when we go on to the public transport, we can, you know, employ the use of technology, you know, listen to our Amitabha singing, chanting of Amitabha, or listen to the Dharma talk. Even like when we on our way to work, if we have a chance, turn on the tune of Amitabha chanting or Dharma talk.So that our heart is constantly in that rhythm, not being put off foot by what's happening to us. Because our objective is to cultivate a heart of equilibrium, a peaceful heart, despite what's happening outside. That's our goal. Otherwise, if the contrast is too big, will take longer time to recover. So we need to practice it every opportune moment we have, you know, between the breaks and stuff like that, so that we are used to the calm and tranquility. Even that thing that we are working on is very busy. We cannot get agitated because of it. We still follow step by step, one by one, just like when we chant.
事可以多，心不能急，不能乱。学佛啊，假如用一句话讲啊，就是不要被境界转。
You can have many matters, you can have many stuff to handle, but your heart cannot be your heart cannot be agitated, because Buddhism has one core principle, if you want to know, that is our heart must not be shifted or moved by the external phenomenon or by anything that happens to us.
You 们听了有要探讨的可以再 feedback 过来。
We would like to have a two-way instead of one-way. So if you guys have any questions, or maybe through my translation, something's not clear, chip in.
啊，不要让他听到这里，他有其他的角度或者有反对意见都可以提出来。
You can even object, or like if you have a different angle, what about this? What about that? Just raise it.
那这个可能要。他在经历的每件事，去观察，我现在心烦意乱，心烦意乱是一个结果，什么原因造成我心烦意乱呢？因为他遇的事情可能有家庭的事情，可能有工作的事情，或者可能有参与公益的事情，那这个。就是要在每一个境缘当中明白造成这个结果的原因在哪。比方说举个例子，很热心，但是是非以物轻诺，弟子规讲的啊，苟轻诺进退处，那很可能这一件事就是在提醒我啊，我要答应人家，可能要衡量我的时间精力，不然我答应了到时候又太累了然后又搞得自己心烦意乱了我是举个例子，不是说他是这样但是就是你就必须，因为有一句话讲叫经一事长一智，我经历每一件事我更了解我自己我更知道怎么去处理事情。
So the result that you're experiencing right now is called effect. Your effect is you are feeling agitated, you're not very at peace. So we need to find out the cause using the law of cause and effect. So what is the cause that makes you felt very agitated? There are many reasons, just suggestions, like maybe from family, maybe from friends, maybe things happening to you.And Venerable has given a more concrete example, like maybe we are very passionate in a project or some matters, but we promise too much. Like in Di Zi Gui, they talk about a phrase where we do not easily promise or we do not easily agree to things that we might not know that we can achieve or not. So don't promise too easily. And because, why? Because yes, we love this. We love this project, we love this thing that happened.But if we promise too much ahead of ourselves, we might get very tired. Especially when we can't achieve that promise, you felt guilty and stuff like that. All sorts of, you know, negative things. So, not saying that you are, but just a suggestion. And it's fine, now that we're aware of this, right? There's a saying goes that we only learn when we experience things. As we experience what happened to us, we will grow our wisdom in, you know, in knowing when to agree, when not to. How much do we agree? How much do we hold back?
就是你会累，就是因为你看到这个事，让你产生的感受，产生的情绪。因为你有情绪的时候啊，你的能量就会消耗的比较厉害。哦，所以我刚刚说的，就是学佛就是不要被境界转。你不被境界转，境界就被你转。所以变成说，哦，孩子很调皮，但我们不能受他们行为影响我的情绪，但不是说一下子都不被影响了，这不可能。但是我们很清楚，我们慢慢不被他们影响，那我可以念佛，让我的心很定。因为我定的时候，我再去处理他们的情况啊，我会处理得更理想。所以修行其实就是在每天发生的事情里面修啊。
The reason why using your example, because you have an example, why you might felt very agitated, we say that is because we may have this, the situation is that we're fighting, making a fuss, we allow that thing to get under us, our skin.Invoking emotions. Emotions spend our energy, our life force, much more than when we were at calm or at peace. And this always goes back to the principle of Buddhist cultivation, unmoved, the state of tranquility, despite what happened. That's what we all have to work on. Not being moved. Not saying that you can do it immediately, no one can.So it's not possible, you can just do it like that. It's a gradual process. But once we reach to that level where we are not letting what happened in front of us getting under our skin, hence not invoking too many emotions, we are able to find it is what it is.
就佛法讲啊，境缘无好丑，好丑起于心。境界没有好丑，是我们的心分别它好跟不好。当你分别它不好的时候，你的心已经在受影响，这样就会影响你的情绪。唉，随他去吧。
这个也不是一个很正面，就是这个意思。
所以其实我们面对的任务再大再重，重点都不是在这件事上，在我的心。我只要把我的心守好了就好了。其实我们在工作的时候也不是很复杂，我只要我每一刻我的心用对了就好了。我不要被我的情绪拉着走，因为我的心好了，我的班级就会慢慢好了。因为这个班级是我的医报，随着我老师的正报转。啊，你不要想，哎呀，那么多孩子，哎呀，好调皮啊！哎呀，你就拉回来，我护好我的心，他们就会。我护好我的心了，我讲的话，我做的事，都会是用真心做出来的，他们也会变好的。举个心境啊，这个也是我教书的一个心路历程啊。今天这一亩田地啊，荒耕了三年了，一个农夫，他很有经验，他来的时候会不会看到这个荒地说，我三个月之后呢，我就要收成。不可能了， 他会想，我花一年的时间、啊、把土质改善改善、哦、我第三年能够收成了、啊、挺好的了。因为他知道大自然的规律啊。那种田跟浇树一样、啊、哎，现在这个孩子来家里已经好几年没浇了，你哪有可能让他明天就变乖了呢？不可能啊。就像我们刚刚说的，万法因缘生，因缘生，这个孩子来到你面前以前，他家庭的因缘已经好多年了，你是他人生的一个缘。所以当老师的心境，岂能尽如人意啊，但求无愧我心啊。你先要把自己的心态摆正确之后，你遇到什么事不会影响你的情绪。不好意思，有点长。
哦，没有，太帮忙烦了。So, I'll make a summary. So Venerable say that、in the situation that we can apply in ours is, I know the matters, the emphasis point is not on what matters, what happens. It's on our attitude, our heart.Have I keep my heart on the equilibrium? Or have I been affected severely, shaking emotion? So to make it easier to understand, he bring out a very nice example. Imagine there's a patch of land laid waste for 3 years, uncultivated, nothing's in it, no fertilizer, nothing. As a farmer, do we expect, hey, I'm gonna make it into a fertile land within 3 months?That's not possible. That's not realistic. What's going to happen is, all right, first year, I'm going to spend some time for it to improve the soil quality, less acidic. Say pH 9, I'll make it pH 7, less acidic. Second year, third year, only then on third year, I will expect some improvements on the cultivation, on the farmland, improvement on the soil quality.So same goes for your student or whatever we're working on. So in your scenario, the students that you teach, their condition was already there since they were born in their family. They were not cultivated. If you're lucky, encounter a kid coming from a family that are cultivated, congratulations. But most of the cases is they already laid waste. That means they are not cultivated for many years before they arrive in your classroom. How can we expect that short,period of time, how much day do we have of them, right? That they will change their behavior suddenly. So as a teacher, just like farming, we cannot, how to say, the expectation is we need to make sure that we're doing our job, like doing what we can do. And when your attitude has changed, they will know, they will see it. And eventually, you know, just like a farmer, 3 years later or something, they will feel it.Not even in your class, but maybe in the future. So just protect our heart first, as in protect our, focus on our action first, reaction to it.
So. 举个例子啊，因为我曾经带过一个班呢、啊，有四大天王，就是一个老师教了40年呢、啊。然后带到这个班呢，他提早退休，他带了半年之后受不了了，我一定要提早退休了，就那后面那一半年就是我教的。哦，那有一个心态非常重要，就是这些学生呢是来成就我的，就是善财童子53餐呢、啊。这个心境在教学在工作当中特别重要，因为我们保持的这个所有都是老师，连这四大天王都是老师，哎，他们给我出题目来了，他考我不能动气啊， 他是来成就我的。那我在面对他们的境界，我在修行。我在往内看我的心，我有没有对立啊？我有没有情绪上来了？那他们就是在锻炼我，这是向内，所以佛法是内学。可是今天我讲了向外，哎呀，今天又给我搞什么名堂出来了，哇，就哎，但是我假如向内我没有被他影响，我就会很稳定的去处理他的事情。
So Buddhism is about internal learning, not focusing on outside. That means we work on the internal stuff first, sort it out before we deal with the outside world. Or when we deal with the outside world, the focus is on internal processes rather than say.This person, that person. So no blame. And best way to do that is like role reversal. Venerable himself was a teacher before. He was being a teacher for many years. And he too has a very, he has experience in dealing with very headache students. In his class, there are Sida Tim, the four troublemakers. The four troublemakers in his class that caused his teacher before him to resign, or maybe like retire halfway to the class. I can't do it anymore, and then pass to Venerable. And then he has to deal with that. So he realized that what we can do in this situation is reverse the role. Everyone is my teacher. These four troublemakers in particular is my sensei, is my master. He's teaching me how to be patient. Every time my heart,goes into anger, temper, temperous mode. That means I'm tested. That means I failed the test. Let's try again. So keep going and keep going. Eventually, improve our ability to withstand this kind of pressure. So, yeah.
因为你的心没有情绪的时候，你就会看情况处理了。哎，人的心定下来的时候，你会就好像我站上台去，我没拿稿啊。对呀，心定下来了，哎，看到这个老菩萨对我笑一下，可能就有灵感了。哦，或者我讲这个重点，他就给我灵感了。所以学生跟你互动的时候，只要你的心是定的。你就是用真心在跟他互动。对呀，我有时候跟学生讲话，讲到我自己都快流眼泪了，被自己感动了。这真的是这样的。但是我就是守好我的心啊。所以我们处理事啊，不要搞复杂，要简单一点。心生种种法生，我的心好了。我的言语行为不会偏，那对方接受到我言语行为是真心，他慢慢慢慢就被我感动了。
Real life example. So I think you can ask about, but we have to deal with stuff at hand. It's our job. The variable say yes, but if we focus on our heart first, rather than get pulled by the situation in front of us.What we do is we're able to deal things as it is. Hence, we're able to find opportunity to reverse the situation because I have hold myself back from being, angry or being swayed by stuff. So I'm able to see things clearer, hence able to find most optimal way to manage the stuff for best way. Because for example, Venerable himselfSometimes when he talk about some very touching stuff, he cry first before other people cry because he's touched by the story that he's presenting and it moves other people as well. I think some of us, including myself, was moved by Venerable's speech in this way as well. So this is what he meant by if you take care of your own heart first, which is your attitude, your speech, your action, your thoughts. Take care of yourself first. You will move to other people, and they will change their behavior when they see that you are for real. You're not just controlling them, trying to tell them to do things. You actually sincerely communicate, reach out to them.
Yeah. 这个呢，从心上看呢、啊，别打了，别打了，你的心是慌张的。陷在里面的，他们所接触到的能量呢，是比较欢乱的。你都不讲话，这个心比较定，哦，反而能够威慑他们。为什么？可能他们在家里，爸爸妈妈啊，别打了，别打了，就他已经习惯这种。但是老师出这一招，他们是没看过的。这个看情况办，但是心很重要。对，你包含你事后还在引导他，代表你并没有陷在情绪里面。对。
So Ben was just giving a confirmation that what he did is correct and very good because he didn't in the beginning you not experience yet, which you have already experienced. You sink into that.Mess, which makes everyone more agitated. What you did later is you able to hold them off by not saying anything. That gives them a different energy than what they experience. And they understand that, oh, suddenly the teacher that keep yelling no longer yells. And then, but you didn't abandon them. You just let them calm down. Afterwards, you calm back, everyone's calm and peaceful. Then you can communicate what is right, what is wrong. So it's good.
就是好，我们今天聊的这些事情啊，我们都回到大乘佛法里面善财童子的表法。善财童子啊，他表的就是当生成就。那他能当生成就呢，他一定一直在提升呢、啊。
So Maggie is trying to ask a question of, say, because Venerable has given a talk about everyone's giving us a test, right? Every situation gives us a test. So if we have a mindset that, okay, I'm being tested right now, then you'll be alert, not fall into the emotions or anything. So she's just asking, is this a correct way to do it? And Venerable confirms it is correct. Because she said that, when can we reach to that level? And so Venerable is trying to give out an example of...三才童子 which is one of the bodhisattvas in the Hua Yin Jing, the flower adornment sutra. So, I'll let Venerable go.
对，因为善财童子呢，他只有我是学生，其他的都是老师来成就我的。他保持这个心态呢，他面对每个人。这个人提醒我什么？好像说，哎，你看到善人恶人，哎，你见人善，你就即思起，你就提升了；见人恶呢，你即内省。那这些境界不都是在让你提升吗？那你保持住了，所以它叫善财，善是善根。财呢是德能福报，只要保持住了，只有我是学生，其他的都是善知识，都是来启发成就，你就会在每一个境界往上提升了。所以他能当生成就，就是在这个很可贵的心态上。
The Bodhisattva name is also very meaningful. 善财 ，so Bodhisattva of good root.And good merits. And he, in this Flower Adornment Sutra, able to attain Buddhahood, one goal, in one breath. So he doesn't have to go many lives. Why? Because he always has the mentality, as Venerable has mentioned, I'm the student, everyone is my master, everyone is my teacher. So everyone is the person that I can learn from. So as Maggie has asked, how do we achieve the level where everything, everyone every second, every moment is good, no matter the situation is adverse or favorable. That's the key point. Treat everyone like your teachers. And how do we learn? If we learn from kind people, people who are really kind and good, we learn by emulating their action, by emulating their heart, by emulating whatever they do. What about from the people who are doing the bad deeds or who is very, how to say, unwholesome, doing very hurtful stuff? You avoid doing what they do. You repulse what they, I mean, you avoid that kind of mentality, the kind of action they are taking. That is the daily process that we need to have in order to attain that level where nothing is bad, despite the situation.
So, 佛这个善财童子，因为我们都是这一生就要脱离六道去极乐世界的，所以我们每个人都要做善财童子。
And this refers to us. This bodhisattva of good root and good fortune actually refers to us, especially when we're practicing Pure Land Buddhism, because we have to finish this whole cultivation in one life, in one breath.
好，那你刚刚有提到了，那我还要多久才能达到，是吧？事事是好事。我们用功呢，就是用功在当下。啊，假如想，哎呀，还要多久啊？啊，那这又是一个烦恼。哦，就是这个，不念未来，不念过去啊。哎，我当下这一念心用对。好，那再来，你还有提到一个重点，你说。好像有时候提得起来，有时候不一定提得起来，那就要变成你要用方法让自己在境界当中能不断提起一个正念，那这个就要靠平常的用功，比方说你多熏习，你有时间不胡思乱想，不打妄想，你就是听经，你一直听经，你的正念就很容易提起来。大家有没有感觉啊？比方听老汉听一个小时听完了，哇，能量比较高了。哦，你保持你那个能量啊，你不能说我听经的时候才有能量啊，怎么办？你在做事的时候，你都用经典老汉的教诲来指导你。你就在你自己的思维就在熏习你自己的，哦，所以像承德的工作量哦挺大的，哦，但是呢，我身累，心呢比较不累，因为毕竟我还是个机器嘛，身体还会，但是因为我们在处理事的时候都是用经教。我用经教思维的那个能量啊，是 positive， 是可以利益我的身心的，所以心不会累，睡一觉就很有精神。你给他翻译，翻译
positive energy。So two stuff. So he follow up with Maggie's question and two point. One is Maggie's asking, how long can I reach to that level where I no longer have to be worried about being moved by outside?And Marabu say Buddhism, I mean, cultivation itself focus on now, now and now. We do not think of past, we don't think of future. The more we think about, oh, when am I going to get that? It's another form of affliction, another form of trouble. So we should avoid that kind of mindset. Just focus on right now. Another point is every day we need to put in the effort. What kind of effort?The mindset. How do we do that? Listen to the Dharma. Listen to the what Master Qing calls Dharma. Because this Dharma gives you the way. Sutra means way, Jing. A way to get out of the situation. If we use this Sutra that we listen by immerse a lot in it, like when you listen to Buddha Dharma, didn't you feel a surge of positive energy? Like I can take on the world after that.But we cannot limit it to only that 1 hour or 2 hours of Dharma talk. We need to use that as an operating principle on our daily life. Oh, the sutra tells me to do that. And then when you face the actual situation, if 放手。
这个当然，念佛的功德力是最大，重，至诚的孝心，念佛，回向给母亲啊，还有他的冤亲债主，因为这个也跟业力有关，但首先呢，心呢要护好，不能慌，
就跟你刚才讲的一样，
对，对。他刚刚说的事事是好事，你心态要积极乐观。你看你心态对了，有可能这一件事啊，你们家里的人都提升了。但是我们心态不对了，可能家里的人都因为这件事痛苦了。所以同样是缘哦，随缘妙用。妙在心啊，不被这个境界啊，让我们烦恼了，让我们这个动心呢、就是你妙用，就是说你不被这件事影响你的情绪，你就可以在这件事产生什么作用呢？产生你在这件事当中。你成长了，这件事里面的其他相关的人也在这件事当中成长了，妙用了，
是的，
作用好的作用。
You have a positive effect, not just simply surrender, but you also bring a positive mindset towards it. Just like what Maggie has said, she wants to attain the level of no matter what happened, adverse or favorable, she wants to turn it into something positive for her.No matter what that condition is, so simple as this.
好，这个我们刚刚一开始就说万法因缘生呢，这句话就包含万法，包含他妈妈生病，这也是一法，都是因缘所生。哦，所以我们学佛之后啊，你看事情呢，你就用因缘去看，哎，今天我母亲的身体，这是一个结果，因是什么，缘是什么，你要把造成这个结果这个不好的因缘，你就要把它调整。从哪些方面调整？从身心还有灵性。这个身大家好理解嘛，你的吃啊，生活习惯啊，都会影响你的身体的，熬夜啊，这个生活作息啊，所以这个《黄帝内经》讲了三句很好，食饮有节啊，就饮食要有节制度，不能有一餐没一餐啊，或者都没有定时，起居有常。生活规律啊，睡觉啊，早睡早起，不忘坐牢，就是不要透支身体。这是三个原理原则，身、心理，因为心理会影响人很多。我那时候说，比方说乳癌，你吃右边、左边呢、都会因为不同的人事境缘造成的，这个男左女右啊。那这个就是心理的问题，那这个你也要能清楚因缘的状态，你妈妈的心情有没有受哪些因素的影响？再来就是灵，因为人有过去生带来的业力，为什么人一算命，哇，我也被算过啊，人家拿去算，40岁到50岁注意身体。我真的这段时间垮下来了，你这么巧，其实那是过去生的一个善恶业在一生当中会现前，但是问题是你用正确的心态，这些境你就可以转，对，啊灵的话，那因为有过去生的业，所以啊，你就要帮你母亲多放生。 然后念佛啊，做功德给他回向，啊，这些冤亲债主得的利益了，他可能就不来障碍了。啊，我举一个例子，前两天台湾有一位法师，释庄信法师，他的父亲90多岁了，突然变了一个人，非常暴躁，结果他就给他父亲念1000部《地藏经》，结果他父亲呢，就完全恢复本来的样子，就不再发脾气了。那就代表他那发脾气是被干扰的，哦，被众生干扰。那这个又持这种大乘经哦，功德力很大，这是属于灵性方面，可以。所以这个要三管齐下，多管齐下来解决问题，因为冰冻三尺，非一日之寒，所以你也要有耐性去应对，这个急不来，啊，但是呢，我们只要保持这个孝心呢，跟佛菩萨就接通了，啊，都会加持你的。哎，是，好，你看讲《地藏经》的时候，十方诸佛都来了。代表人孝心起来的时候，感应的加持力是很大的。好，至于过程有什么，可以再探讨。好，现在有一个关键啊，你就要时时让自己保持，让自己提升。所以像我那时候教书吧，工作量很大，我一有时间我就听经。所以我车上都是老和尚的光，这个录音带在播，让我随时保持在很好的状态。所以你可以听经，你也可以念佛。还有一点特别重要，你在工作的时候，在讲话处理事的时候呢，你也是用经教在做事情。啊，你不能听经的时候啊很好，做事的时候呢，你没有把经教用上，哦，那你在办事的时候，我们的习气也会现前。啊，你比方说，哇，脾气上来了，那功德都烧掉了，哦，那个整个状态就保持不了了。啊，所以生活、工作、处事待人呢，我们慢慢养成一个习惯，用经教来思维。来指导我们一言一行，好。